Hi, in this short video, I want to demonstrate how you can benefit from the trackBy function in Angular. trackBy is a feature of the ngFor structural directive that can be a good optimization for your Angular app. In this example, I have a list of users. I use an ngFor directive to render each user using a user details component. To visualize that the components are created, I added an Angular animation, which shows an animation whenever an element is added or removed in the DOM, that is, when Angular creates or destroys a component. I also added console logs in some of the lifecycle hooks of this component, the first one in the ngOnInit method, which is called when the component is created, and one inside the ngOnChanges, which is called when Angular detects changes in the input binding, and one in ngOnDestroy that is called when this component is destroyed. Now, when I refresh the page, you will see the enter animation. Now, I have this refresh button over here, which calls the refresh method. And the refresh method will replace the list with a new list, which is your realistic scenario. For example, the same happens when you fetch data using HTTP. Now, when I hit refresh, you will see that the previous components are removed and that three new components are created. You can also see that this happens in the console. This happens because Angular checks each object by its reference. And when an object is different, it treats it as a new object and it renders a new view container for that object. However, in this use case, I only want a new component to be created for the new user. I want to update the existing components. I can achieve that by adding a trackBy function, like this. TrackBy event is the name of the function it refers to, so I need to implement it. The function is called with index as first argument and the object, which is the user, as second argument. In this case, I want to track the object by its ID property, so like this. As you can see, when I hit refresh, the component tree now remains the same for the first two users, and a new component was created for the third user. The benefit is that this is more efficient and your page reacts more fluently when it receives new data. Keep in mind that the component should support getting updated with new data. For example, I can calculate the user's name length using this. I have a name length, which is a number, and let's say that the name length is this user's name dot length, and I want to show it in the component template name length. However, when the new data gets populated, the first two components are now outdated. That is because we need to move this logic here to the ngOnChanges of the component. This will support the longer lifecycle of this component. I hope you guys liked this video. Please let me know by subscribing or give your feedback in the comment section below. Thank you for watching.